plan on my back, problem. I appreciate that very much.
Please do, but sorry for the occasion.
Exactly. Well, Mr. President, first of all, I'm very grateful for the opportunity to hear this and see you and talk with you in person. We've had some exchange as county officials that the new federalism initiative not be abandoned. I know in the phone call that you made to me back in late August that you said that you had not abandoned it, and that you were going to continue along the same line. But it is essential to us, politically essential to us, both Republicans and Democrats, that we have some deadlines.
No, no, I was
need a few more.
Actually, it's from that moment to later. That's what happened today. And we ought to put down the end of the day. Welcome, and I know you've got some things you want to talk about, so who's on first?
We'll let Margaret start on.
Thank you, Mr. President. Vice President, I would like to give you a very overview, very honest analysis of the condition of the city's September 1982 pieces of legislation, and that will always be. I think it's safe to say that we are totally together on one opinion, and that is that the cities are in terrible trouble. And I am personally led to the conclusion, although perhaps some would argue that we're doing better in Phoenix than the reductions. We represent some 14%, but only the exact figures your staff can tell you. Of the budget, and we have about 33% of the cuts. And we, many of us, have supported the reductions, the budget cuts, to a certain extent, because we realize that what's good for the cities, and that will not be